tonight for a rivalry game that's been played 105 times. Great players like Brian Bosworth, Barry Sanders, and Thurman Thomas have given the state of Oklahoma the thrills of a gridiron in-state war. Simply known as Bedlam. From Barry Switzer to Bob Stoops and Bud Wilkinson before them, OU has owned the series with only 5 losses since World War II. But under Mike Gundy, that gap has started to close with a veteran quarterback in Brandon Whedon and a Biletnikoff winner in wide receiver Justin Blackman. On the end of his passes, the Cowboys find themselves as the favorites for the third year in a row. No longer the little brothers, the Sooners, the Cowboys, Bedlam, next. And while this is not an official Big 12 championship like we've had in past years, it is a de facto championship because the winner is the Big 12 conference champion and will go to a BCS bowl. That's what it's all about as these two teams get together. Welcome everybody, Brad Nessler along with Todd Blackledge. Partner, they've been doing this thing since 1904. 8 straight losses the Cowboys have suffered at the hands of the Sooners. And even though we talked about stats all week and before the game leading up to it, I think it's all up here. Do they have it in their mind that they can beat these guys?
That's the question that has to be answered. And, you know, the way that Oklahoma State can throw the football and the problems that Oklahoma has had stopping the pass, they may never have a better chance to beat Oklahoma than this year. That's the thing that they've got to do. But, you know, the problem is the guys wearing crimson and cream, they're used to playing for championships.
Right.
And they're used to playing on a big stage. So even though the game is here in Stillwater for the second year in a row, make no mistake, to get where Oklahoma State wants to go, that road goes through Norman.
Well, how do they do it, the Cowboys, on their home field? Some keys to the game.
Well, the keys to the game, when you take a look at both teams, first of all, for Oklahoma, they've got to win the running game. Last 2 weeks ago, Iowa State was able to hold Oklahoma State to 60 yards and one-dimensionalize that offense. If Oklahoma does that, that'll help them get their second key, affect Brandon Whedon. That can come in pressures and hits or sacks, but it also can be in disguising coverages and creating confusion. Last year, they didn't sack him, but they did force 3 interceptions. For Oklahoma State, on the other hand, they have to protect their quarterback. Because Whedon is not a running threat, Oklahoma is going to throw all kinds of different pressures at him. They must communicate and protect. And then finally, they've got to win the turnover battle. They force more turnovers than anybody in college football.
Brandon Whedon, at age 28, coming out obviously with the seniors, one of 16 seniors, as Mike Gundy gives them a set-off. And he'll get a huge ovation for what he's done and what he's continued to do this year for this team. One of the guys that will be introduced that is not a senior, he'll get the same kind of ovation, expected to go to the National Football League. One of the great receivers in college football, the Biletnikoff winner from last year, playing his final game at home, Justin Blackman. And here in Stillwater, as you take a look at the Bedlam history, dates back to 1904. We talked about Oklahoma having won 8 straight. What's at stake tonight? BCS game. And it's been a very, very tough weeks, couple of weeks around this campus, Holly.
Well, that's right. The morning of their game at Iowa State, Oklahoma State heard of the tragedy. They'd lost some members of their athletic family. Women's basketball coach Kurt Budke and his assistant Miranda Cerna and the pilot and his wife were killed in a small plane crash. It really shook the team. We talked to Brandon Whedon and he said the whole day was just a roller coaster of emotions. It was somber. Mike Gundy said we'll never know for sure how that loss affected the way they played in their only loss of the season, but that's not what's important. He said the next morning he went to the widow's home. Shelly Budke opened the door, and the first thing she said to Mike Gundy, "Coach, I'm so sorry about the game, but this community and team has had a chance to move on and heal." They had a lovely memorial, and Justin Blackman showed us in the pregame they're wearing wristbands to honor Kurt tonight, guys.
Not only are they wearing the wristbands, but the Oklahoma coaches are wearing an orange ribbon on their coaching jackets. Oklahoma's going to get the football first. Trey Franks will have to take a knee in the end zone. And that'll bring out the Sooner offense led by this guy, Landry Jones.
Well, last year in this ballgame, Landry Jones set a school record with 468 yards passing.
Problem was 3 interceptions.
Yeah, he threw 3 interceptions, but he threw 4 touchdowns and his team won. So,
interceptions don't hurt as much when you win.
Yep.
So first down for Oklahoma. Sooners at their own 20. Roy Finch in the pistol set behind Landry Jones.
The quick throw out complete to Kenny Stills. And Stills goes for about five. Justin Gilbert made the stop as we take a look at our Oklahoma impact players. Landry Jones, Blake Bell. You'll see both quarterbacks, especially Bell, in short yardage and goal line. Kenny Stills with that catch. He's the number one receiver, of course. Travis Lewis defensively leads them, as he always seems to, in tackles. Here's another throw out and complete, and a first down throw to DeJuan Miller. So two quick passes, first down Oklahoma.
And you have two teams that like to play quick. Both of them are tempo teams. They like to get to the line of scrimmage. You'll see neither team huddle. That doesn't mean they're always going to snap it fast, but they always have the threat of snapping it fast.
From the 31-yard line. Blitz. Jones got rid of it, but it's incomplete. James Hanna, the tight end, had his hands on it, couldn't hold it.
This pass offense for Oklahoma is different without Ryan Broyles, who was the all-time leading receiver in college football, got injured in the Texas A&M game. They still have decent numbers, but it's a different pass offense. Ryan on the sidelines right now.
Ryan had his knee surgery about a week and a half ago. Second and 10. Pump fake, and now the throw is too high. Intended for Hanna, the tight end, again. A couple of errant throws by Landry Jones.
A little confusion created by the defense, Bill Young's defense. You don't have to see Landry Jones have to double clutch too often and move his feet when there's no pressure, and he got confused on the last two plays.
Brings up third and 10. Sooners 43% on their third down conversions on the year. They'll have to earn all of this one. Deep middle. Into traffic. Broken up. Tipped. Incomplete. And it was James Thomas back there that got a hand on it.
Well, again, coming into the game, nobody has forced more turnovers than Oklahoma State, 37, and they almost got one there. They got the tip. The ball was up in the air. And a very interceptable pass. A lot of coverage there around Hanna.
Three passes aimed at Hanna, and the last one he paid the price after it was tipped and incomplete. He took one right under the chin. Press way to punt. Ooh, they got close, but they might have gotten too close.
Nope, no flag.
No flag, and backpedaling is Josh Cooper to take the fair catch. 50-yard punt, no return. Wade just got this away.
Well, they came from outside. They came from inside. Zach Craig was the first guy in, coming on the inside. Very close to getting that punt.
Good call, though. They never touched him, I don't think, at all. He hit the turf on his own just trying to get out of the way. So now Brandon Whedon and the Cowboys work from their 20-yard line. Touchdown passes for Brandon Whedon, and he comes up throwing on a slip screen. Justin Blackman broke one tackle and picked up about six. Let's take a look at the Cowboys impact players. Obviously, Brandon Whedon, the quarterback I just mentioned. Joe Randall, over 1,000 yards on the ground. Blackman, the defending Biletnikoff Award winner, and Jamie Blatnick leads the team in tackles for loss and sacks on the defensive side of things. Whedon down the middle. This one he's got on the run. Tracy Moore. Moore inside the 20 to the 15. Whedon to Moore.
Tracy Moore did a great job of creating separation after he pushed upfield on this route. You're going to see him come from the left of the screen. Watch him separate from the defender. That's Ebolia that he separated from, a pretty good coverage guy. Excellent job creating separation before the catch.
First down in the red zone for the Cowboys. Randall, right side, diving his way inside the 10. Tony Jefferson knocked him off his pins, but the first true threat of the night's coming from Oklahoma State.
And this is where you've got to be careful for Justin Blackman. Because of his ability to go up and catch the football in traffic and use that strong body, You almost have to throw double coverage at him around the end zone.
It's not that he's that tall. He's only 6'1", but as Todd said, he knows how to time his leaps, and he's got extremely strong hands, great hands. Second down and 4. Whedon kind of looks out there at him as Cooper comes in motion. They keep it on the ground, and this is going to be a touchdown. Jeremy Smith. The 8th rushing touchdown of the year for Jeremy Smith. And Oklahoma State on the board first. Extra point by Sharp is good. Midway through the first quarter, Cowboys on the board first. Smith scores from 9 yards out, and at home, Oklahoma State 7, Sooners nothing. Jeremy Smith, the sophomore out of Tulsa Union High, scores to end a 68-yard drive.
Well, a couple things to watch. Parker Graham's going to get a great block right here on Nelson, and then watch Tony Jefferson, because he is going to have his eyes on Justin Blackman, who's out here looking to double cover, and he's not going to see the back get the football until it's too late. Jefferson sees it when it's time to go in the end zone for Jeremy Smith.
Sharp's kick bounces at the 5, taken in the end zone, down by Trey Franks, and Oklahoma trailing by a touchdown.
Only 15 yards of offense.
Jones completes it. First down to Kenny Stills, and Stills is out to the 35.
This is an offense coming into the game, fourth in the country. 548 yards a game that they're averaging. Landry Jones still having a tremendous season. Again, the absence of Ryan Broyles and the absence of tailback Dominique Whaley, who broke his ankle, has affected this offense to a very large degree.
Jones without a huddle, throwing far side this time, and DeJuan Miller was thinking about how much he was going to get out of that game, but he forgot to take the football along.
First things first.
Royals, and they definitely missed the all-time leading receiver in college football history.
He was averaging 128 yards per game in receiving yards, so that's a big chunk of your offense gone.
Second and 10, just shaded on the Sooner side of midfield. Jones, pressure coming, got rid of it to the far side, and this time it is caught by Miller. And forward progress is going to give him the first down.
Yeah, Miller kept his eye on it that time. I mean, he went up, secured that ball into his body, and kept his eyes right on that football the entire way.
Quickly, Sooners snap it and going deep again to the corner. And it is jump ball between Reynolds and whoever's under him, and I don't know who's got it. The Cowboys do. Broderick Brown outfought Reynolds for the football.
Well, Bob Stoops clapping because it's almost like a punt, but for Broderick Brown, the 22nd interception of the season for Oklahoma State, a beautiful play. Broderick Brown was the guy who was involved in one of the best plays in all of college football last season. Goes up and makes a huge pick in the end zone and fights Reynolds for the football.
His 5th interception of the season. A great individual effort by Broderick Brown. And the Cowboys have got it back at their 20. So Landry Jones, his 13th interception of the season. That's what Todd was talking about. Coming in, they know how to swipe the ball. They might give up a lot of yards, but they know how to take it away. And that goes down the middle and completes it. Isaiah Anderson's got a first down.
That ball looked like it bounced. I mean, and some of the Oklahoma defenders were calling for that as well. It was a little bit underthrown. Oh, I think he got it.
Yep, 19-yard pickup.
Excellent concentration by Anderson.
Anderson has never caught a pass against Oklahoma. That's his first one. Now Whedon comes up firing again. Crossing pattern to Blackman. He's got another first down. Trying to fight him for the football, but he holds on to that one.
There are certain routes, if you anticipate double coverage, that you can still try to work to your top guy. That's one of them, an in route. A corner route is another route. It's a deep in, so even if there's underneath and over the top coverage, you still run away from one guy and get into an open space for the football.
Blackman took a pretty good double team hit down there, but held onto the ball. Whedon going to throw to Randall on the other side. And Oklahoma there to meet him. Ebole with the stop.
Back-to-back screen plays for Oklahoma State. Todd Monken expecting pressure from this Oklahoma defense. It was interesting when he talked about Oklahoma's defense. They're a very aggressive, competitive coaching staff defensively. They don't like to give you anything. So they're really going to try to come at you and affect your quarterback and take things away.
Brandon Whedon hands it off this time to Smith, who's already scored a touchdown, and now he spins his way for a first down at the 22-yard line. We know these teams are going to bowls. We just don't know where yet. First down, Cowboys. Crossing pattern, Blackman on the run. Heads to the sideline. Picked up 7 or 8 before he's run out of bounds.
I'm not so sure that that's a good defensive philosophy right there, allowing Blackman to run across the middle of your defense with nobody around him. There were no white shirts around Justin Blackman as he caught that crossing route.
Well, here they are at the 16-yard line. Brent Venables, the defensive coordinator, trying to slow down the Cowboy offense that has already scored once on the ground. And now they've moved it down to a second down and 3 at the 16. They stay with the ground game. Randall's got a first down. He's at the 11.
See, I think that's the key right now for Oklahoma State. They're winning the battle running the football. That's over 50 yards now in the first half, rushing the football to go along with the passing game that coming into the game, best in the league, over 400 yards a game. So it's their ability to have balance on offense right now that has this Oklahoma defense on their heels.
And their only loss 2 weeks ago to Iowa State, they only had 60 yards on the ground. And now Whedon off play action. Scans the field, goes to the corner, throws this one away. Josh Cooper was the closest man, but there was good coverage by the Sooners.
Yeah, good decision that time by Whedon. You know you've got a certain amount of time, and that's it. And you don't want to take a sack because you've got offensive momentum. Throw that thing away.
Well, this is the 9th play of the drive. They started this way back at their own 20-yard line. Blackman won't be in on this snap. On a second down and 10. They can get a first down at the 1.
Blackman out. Cooper becomes the main guy.
Hand off Smith. And they're holding on for dear life as he crossed the 10-yard line. Corey Nelson will bring him down.
Travis Lewis was the first guy to get into the backfield and slow down Jeremy Smith. He didn't get the tackle. Nelson got the tackle, but Lewis created the problem.
And now on 3rd and 8, Blackman is back in there, and it would be almost impossible to get a first down without getting a touchdown, because the first down marker is just inside the 1. Trying to go up by 2 scores here. The Cowboys, 3rd down and 8. Whedon throws complete to Blackman, but he's run out of bounds after a pickup of only about 1 yard.
It's a big difference that time on the crossing route. There was somebody right with him. Travis Lewis picked him up right away. Even though it was a completion, it wasn't anywhere near the first down.
Quinn Sharp is not only the punter, but the place kicker as well. And he is 17 out of 20 on the year on his field goals. This should be a chip shot, 25 yards. Sharp, the kick is up and good. And the Cowboys have added to their lead on their home field. Sooners have spotted them 10 with 2:51 remaining first quarter. Here, Big 12 conference title on the line, and right now it's Oklahoma State leading 10-0.
You know, that's a weapon. When your kicker kicks it out of the end zone for touchbacks as much as Oklahoma State's kicker does, Quinn Sharp, I mean, that's a weapon.
Brandon Williams is the tailback, and he'll get the carry. And Williams, with a stiff arm, got about 5. this for the Big 12 conference title, even though it's not the championship game that's been played over the course of several years at a neutral site. The winner of this one does win the conference at a BCS berth. Here's a pass out to Kenny Stills. First down, stiff arms his way out to the 32-yard line. As we look at our conference update brought to you by Dr. Pepper 10. And here's how it looks. Oklahoma State, number 3 in the BCS, Oklahoma, number 10. But by virtue of head-to-head competition, whoever wins this one has a BCS berth.
How about Bill Snyder's Kansas State Wildcats?
Not bad, huh?
10-2.
Miller, the fullback in motion, the handoff, and stood up and dropped for a loss is Williams. And it was Christian Littlehead who met him head-to-head in the hole.
And the inside, Littlehead beats the center, Ben Haburn. Now Haburn is back, had a broken forearm, missed 5 games, was back last week at center against Iowa State for the first time.
2nd and 10, here comes a blitz. Jones steps in, fires a strike, complete. Got it to Miller, the fullback. Big gain and a first down. Pick up a 23.
A lot of times the reason young freshman running backs don't play all the time is because they don't pick up pass protection as quick as running the football. But this time, watch Brandon Williams stick his nose right in there and buy enough time for his quarterback to make the throw.
It was probably the best throw by Jones tonight. Back to the ground to Williams. Again, Brandon Williams getting more and more time. True freshman to end the first quarter. A quarter belonging to the Cowboys of Oklahoma State on their home field. They lead 10-0. This presentation of ESPN on ABC College Football, presented by Southwest Airlines, continues after this message and a word from our ABC stations. We end up with two of the best teams playing for the conference crown in what's been a strange year in the Big 12. Texas A&M and Missouri going to the SEC. West Virginia and TCU coming in. Talked to Chuck Nines, the interim commissioner, before the game down on the field. And of course, a lot of it was caused by the Longhorn Network, which almost disbanded this whole conference. Luckily, we got the two teams that everybody wanted to see play each other playing here tonight in Stillwater. Jones, long throw on 2nd and 8. Gets right on the money of Kenny Stills. And Landry Jones in a groove right now. Lance, he's hit his last 4.
Yeah, this is a tempo offense, a rhythm pass offense, and Landry Jones shows that arm strength again. The deep out route with not much air under the football, very difficult to defend.
Todd McShay, our draft expert, has Andrew Luck as the number 1 quarterback. Matt Barkley, if he comes out, as number 2. They've got Landry Jones in that top 3 or 4.
Yeah, he's listed as 3. Robert Griffin III also listed in that top 5, the kid from Baylor.
Finch, again, somehow slips through and gets almost 4 yards. All 5'7", 166 pounds of it. I would think Brandon Weeden would be in the discussion about top quarterbacks, too. I know the fact that he's 28 years old might scare some people, but...
Well, Todd McShay has him as a 2nd or 3rd rounder. I think he might be a little bit better than that, personally. Very accurate thrower. Great arm.
Of course, there's precedence in that drafting a 28-year-old. Chris Wenke was basically the same age. And he came out of Florida State as a Heisman Trophy winner. 2nd down and 6. 2 tight ends set. Clock winding down, play clock at 4. Pressure coming on Jones. They pick it up. He throws, and it's tipped and almost intercepted by Justin Gilbert. Trying to throw a streak down there in the corner, intended for Kenny Stills.
Well, I mentioned how much he's missed Ryan Broyles in 2 key areas, on 3rd down and in the red zone. And Landry Jones in the red zone the last few weeks has really struggled.
Stills was out of bounds anyway. 9th play of the Sooner drive. They started this way back at their own 22-yard line. They don't want to miss this opportunity. Trailing by 10 with under 5 to go in the half. Boy, everybody up close for the Cowboys. They're going to bring that many. They are. Jones running for his life.
That's a
ball
fumble.
Is out, and it's scooped up by Blotnick, and he might go. Blotnick down the sideline. Still on his feet. Inside the 5. 59-yard fumble return, and the Cowboys are at the one-yard line.
Alex Elkins, the linebacker, number 37, is going to come unblocked and strip the football. Landry Jones is trying to throw it away to avoid a sack, to at least kick a field goal, and he can't get rid of the football. And then Blacknick shows some speed down the sideline, almost getting it to the end zone. But Alex Elkins, with the inside blitz, stripped the football. And what a huge turnaround play for the Cowboys.
Blacknick made one of the captains for this game. Showing why. Having a great first half, and he set up the offense at the Sooner one-yard line.
What a turnaround. Momentum for Oklahoma. A good drive. At least they're going to get 3 points. And now they might go down 17.
A full house backfield loaded to the right. For that man, Joe Randle. Touchdown. Joseph Randle's 22nd rushing touchdown of the year. And right now it's all Cowboys.
Well, they overload to the side. Staley and Paulson, the two fullbacks in, clearing the way.
17-0. OSU. A one-yard drive in one play. But the play that set it up was the captain from Salina, Texas, who scoops and almost scored. His tailback did it for him on the next snap. 17-0. The reaction in Ganbare, Afghanistan, the brigade headquarters for a lot of the National Guardsmen from Oklahoma. And obviously Cowboy fans cheering, Sooner fans unhappy. 17-0. The Cowboys in front on a huge defensive play by Jamie Blatnick, who took it all the way down to the one-yard line. And then Joseph Randle did the rest. And now the Sooners are in some trouble.
You know, when Mike Gundy said to us yesterday, I don't care, we're not the 107th defense. I wasn't sure I believed him, but tonight, boy, they sure have proven it.
Sooners have had 6 possessions, 4 punts, and a couple of turnovers. And the kick return, flags go down as Trey Franks doesn't even make the 20-yard line. And this is a fired up group of Cowboys right now. Inside the 10 for the Sooners. They move Miller, the fullback, goes right back to where he started as Williams goes that way. And they've got him all wrapped up for a loss of a couple. Guess who? The guy that just made the big play on the previous series comes up with a stop on that one. Now you got to be kind of careful here, too. I mean, you throw an errant pass.
Yep.
The Cowboys, the way they've been stealing things, they might steal another one. And that would be a disaster. They fake the draw. Jones from his own goal line. And now in his own end zone. And he throws it away.
Oklahoma looks all out of sorts. Left tackle Donald Stevenson getting into a little scrape at the end of the play with Richetti Jones. And, you know, when things are going like this, you kind of lose your focus. The helmet comes off. And at this point, Donald Stevenson, I mean, he turns it into a one-on-one deal, and Landry Jones has to throw the football away.
3rd and 11. Jones again in his own end zone. Fires down the middle, high and incomplete. Intended for Hannah, the tight end. And now the Sooners, a quick 3-and-out, and they're going to have to kick with their punter backed up to his own end line.
Well, it's pretty easy to answer the question, which defense has been able to affect the opposing quarterback the most? Hands down, Oklahoma State has affected Landry Jones much more than the Sooners have gotten to Brandon Weeden.
Remember, this group of Cowboys has really gotten in Tressway's way trying to punt tonight. Let's see if they bring the heat on him again. They did, but he got it out of there. And Cooper on a fair catch. Great field position for the Cowboys with all their timeouts remaining and 3:36 left in the quarter. Right now, Oklahoma State is winning the battle by big margin. Trying to add to it, but a nice play by Demontre Hurst to break up that pass to Josh Cooper.
Actually, that was a pretty good play by Josh Cooper to break up an interception, too. You could go either way on that because the ball was kind of thrown into traffic. And Hurst had a shot at it, and Cooper did a nice job of turning from offense to defense as well.
Right now, the Sooners would just like to come up with a stop. Inside handoff, look out, Randall! Tripped up. Tony Jefferson saved a touchdown. But a 32-yard run by Joseph Randall.
Well, the center, watch the center get a block on the linebacker, Lewis. Does a great job of sealing the inside on Travis Lewis, and that was all that Randall needed to get to the next level.
Whedon back to work, flips it out to Randall. Stop for no gain by Aaron Colvin.
Now that center, Grant Garner, a senior, has been battling a bad ankle since the A&M game. Really did a nice job of getting out in front of that play, getting to the second level, and springing the back.
Jeremy Smith comes in. He's going to give Randall a breather in the Cowboy backfield. Brandon Whedon trying to get him lined up. Second down at 10. Three receivers to the left. Whedon's looking that way. Throws a quick in to Cooper. Spins out of one tackle. Can't get away from Travis Lewis.
Well, just no pressure at all on Brandon Whedon. I mean, he's too accurate of a guy to allow to throw in rhythm, to put his back foot in the ground, and to just throw when he wants to. You've got to make him move his feet to move him off his mark, and Oklahoma has not been able to do that.
He doesn't even have a wrinkle in his jersey, much less a grass stain. Quick throw, tucking it into traffic. They're trying to rip it out of there, but they can't. That's a first down throw, and it's first and goal to Blackman.
Yeah, good luck trying to rip the ball out from him. You might rip it out of some other guys. It'll be pretty tough to rip that ball out of his arm.
Now the Cowboys threatening again. First and goal at the 5. Handoff, Smith to the 2.
Well, the last time they were in this area, they brought in their extra backs. They ran a power play. Even though they're in the shotgun, they still can run a power, kind of a goal line run. They bring Staley, number 9, and Paulson, number 30, into the game.
The last time they got down close, they showed the same setup. And then they brought another back into the near side and gave it to Randall, and he scored from a yard out. It's second and goal at the 2. They do the same thing to the left. Randall gets a call, and he scores again. Touchdown, Oklahoma State.
Well, that was great blocking by the center, Garner, the right guard, Lane Taylor. Both of those extra backs got in there. Lane Taylor, the right guard, just wiped out half of the defensive front.
24-0.
Watch Lane Taylor, the right guard, just cave in the defense. The backs follow through the hole, and Randall walks into the end zone untouched.
24-0 with just over a minute to play in the half. Quinn Sharp to kick. Knocks it deep. Franks, 5 yards in, will take a knee.
Maybe.
Slip screen, Trey Franks. He's going to cross all the way over to the other side of the field to get the 5 yards that he got. And Justin Gilbert put him down over there. Well, you got to, if you're a Sooner fan, think, you know what, we score 43 points a game. Somewhere along the line we're going to score to try to get back in it. I don't know if they've got enough time to get back in it before halftime with a touchdown, but that's what they're looking for. And down the middle, and that was almost intercepted, but it was caught by Trey Franks.
Yeah, the reason it was caught is because Franks kept coming towards the ball. You want a receiver to move towards the ball to cut off the defender, and that's what Franks did.
First down at the 39. Landry Jones pressured, throws it. Roy Finch is going to get out of bounds after getting what he can.
That's interesting. You know, when you think of a rivalry game, it's really not a great rivalry unless both teams kind of win their share. And This has been so dominated by Oklahoma.
Oklahoma's got all its timeouts remaining. They got to cover a lot of ground here, try to get a touchdown before halftime. Pressure coming off the corner. Sooners pick it up. Landry Jones goes back the other way, completes it. James Hanna, the tight end, got a first down and out of bounds at the 42.
Now, right now, if you're Landry Jones, I mean, you got to think, we got to at least get in position to try a field goal. We need some points on the board before halftime.
Jones again to Stills this time. He's shoved out of bounds, but he's got a first down at the 31.
That's why you work the sidelines here. Even though you have timeouts, you work the sideline to stop the clock. You got those timeouts in case you want to take a shot in the middle, you can stop the clock with a timeout.
Landry Jones has hit his last five. I give the Sooners offensive line credit. They're picking up the Cowboy blitzes pretty well to give Jones at least enough time to get rid of the ball. And this time he goes incomplete. And it was Broderick Brown. He's made some nice plays on the corner. Kamil Jackson is the intended receiver. Broderick Brown, remember, he had the interception in the end zone that thwarted a Sooner drive earlier in this half. Final 8 seconds now. Maybe time for two plays, depending on how deep you throw it.
Well, it's either got to be one really quick one or you take a shot at the end zone.
It's going to be the quick one, and it's over the head of Kamil Jackson, and now they'll have one deep throw. Kenny Stills has been the number one target tonight for Landry Jones.
See, they wanted one more completion just to make this a little better, easier attempt. They got to get points. I mean, that's what Bob Stoops is saying. We got to have something that we can hang our hat in when we go to the locker room to give us some kind of momentum to come out and play the second half.
Honeycutt is hit from 53 this year. So this is in his range from 48. And it hit the right upright, and it went through. Wow, that was a lucky ricochet. But like Todd said, take anything you can get right now. If that's momentum, I don't know. A 48-yard field goal. Michael Honeycutt, and he couldn't have cut it any closer than right here as it skims off the upright and in as we check in with Holly.
Well, Coach, your defense has been maligned at times this season, but what would you say they've done to be so disruptive in this first half?
Well, they've been very active. They're running the ball really well, and they're getting their hands on some of those passes down the field, so we just got to keep it up.
Your running game really helped set a momentum early. How were you able to do that?
Well, we worked hard on running the football the last couple weeks. We need to continue to run the ball in the second half.
We know they can come back. They've got firepower. What do you have to do in the second half not to let up?
Well, our kids are prepared, and they'll play hard. They got to come out and keep executing in all three phases.
Thanks, Coach.
Trying to snap an 8-game losing streak to the Sooners and make a BCS game as Big 12 champions. They're halfway there, 24-3, as we go to John Saunders in our studio for the Capital One Halftime Report. John? Here at halftime, it's a brighter moment if you're a Cowboy fan as you take a look at the halftime statistics. 254 to 204, but the turnovers and the points off, that's the key to the whole ball game right now, with the exception of the fact that Oklahoma State's been able to run the ball and Oklahoma hasn't. Welcome back, everybody. Brad Nessler, Ty Blackledge. My partner looks much tougher than me because he doesn't have a coat or gloves on, and you are tougher than me.
No.
Somebody's going to have to get tough in this second half, though, or this one's going to get away from Oklahoma.
Yeah, I'll tell you, the thing that has surprised me the most in the game so far, I expected Brandon Weeden and the Oklahoma State offense to move the football, score points. They've done it all year. But the Oklahoma State defense has played better than I ever anticipated. Yeah. Now, they've stopped Oklahoma. They forced them off the field on third down. And they've done what they've done all year, which is forced turnovers. They're 38th and 39th forced turnover of the season.
I almost kidded around about the coach because it's dropped several degrees and the wind has really picked up, and it could be a factor for sure in the second half. That ball bobbled at the one. Justin Gilbert will go back and take a knee as we check in with Holly Rowe.
Well, checking in with Oklahoma coach Bob Stoots at the half. Obviously, he's frustrated. He said his defense hasn't been playing good run defense. Their linebackers have gotten out of some of their gaps, and they've just missed tackles. But more importantly, he's frustrated with his offense. He said penalties and drop passes, particularly on the plus side of the 50-yard line, have killed him. He said, we're moving the ball. We just have made so many mistakes. We haven't put points on the board. He said with 4 minutes left in the first quarter, it was 10-0. We thought we could handle that, but things just slipped away.
Well, Bob Stoops has won eight straight, 10-2 overall against the Cowboys. They would love to get a stop to open up the third quarter. Brandon Weeden wants points down the middle, overshot. Tracy Moore, who he hit on a 53-yarder in the first quarter of this game. But you always want to see a three and out if you're trailing from your defense on the first series of the third.
Well, they got the points right before they went to the locker room, barely. Now they need their defense to step up.
Justin Blackman, they flip it to him on a sweep, and Blackman's got a first down. Just an underhand toss to his number one receiver this time from Weeden.
Yeah, they use that motion. They don't often use it with Blackman, and I think it kind of fooled the Oklahoma defense. He's not the fastest receiver, but he got out there with a lot of green grass in front of him.
So first down at the 33 for the Cowboys. And that's Cooper on the move. Weeden, who hasn't been touched tonight. Blackman, first down at the 47.
Well, I talked about both of these quarterbacks in the game and the strength of their arm. There's Weeden's example. Left hash, right sideline, deep out route. Very little air under the ball, thrown to the outside. Very, very difficult to defend. If the corner gives the receiver some cushion, hard to make a play on it.
Blackman, after back-to-back first downs, gets a breather. Michael Harrison comes into his spot. Weeden, they almost got to him that time, and it's Harrison who just came in who makes the catch.
Well, what a beautiful throw, because Corey Nelson came unblocked, and Brandon Weeden didn't flinch. I mean, he just stayed right in there and adjusted the throw. Watch Nelson come from the top, unblocked, and Weeden just stays in there and slings it out there.
Gives it to Joseph Randall on a little counter, faking the pass and giving it to him on an inside handoff. Got two before Travis Lewis made the hit. Travis Lewis making his 52nd career start for that defense of Oklahoma. As Todd said, been playing with a bad foot, a broken toe all year long. That thing won't heal until probably about late February, if he's lucky, after the bowl games. Weeden flares it out. Smith taken down by his jersey by Fleming.
And we showed Jefferson almost getting that interception, the free safety. He actually has been a outside linebacker, kind of a nickelback type player for most of the season. They moved him to free safety for this game. He replaced Javon Harris. And he's done pretty well back there for his first week in that position.
And they stop the Cowboys on third and five. Blackman was in motion. They flare it out to him. He's not going to get to the sticks. Pushed out of bounds after a yard gain by Colvin. So that's a victory of sorts for the Sooners defense. Unless the Cowboys go for this thing, I don't think they're going to. I got to think they're going to bring out the field goal unit.
You mentioned the wind. They're kicking with the wind, it appears, right now on this kick. But when this game started, the flag was dead still. remember talking to Bob Stoops on the field, saying we had a perfect night.
Yep.
No wind at all, and it has increasingly gotten windier and colder.
Sharp will try a 37-yard field goal. He hit a short one earlier in the ball game. The kick out of the way, and it is perfect. Three more for Oklahoma State, but it could have been worse if you're a Sooner fan. They hold him to a field goal. 12:02 to go, third quarter. These guys trying to win the Big 12 conference title. Just went 60 yards in 9 plays. Quinn Sharp with a 37-yard field goal, capping things off. Whedon was 4-for-6 on that drive, and with that, over 4,300 passing yards, breaking his own school record last season when he had 4,277. And that guy just went over the single-season reception mark that he set last year when he had 111, 112.
Not a bad couple of years for those two,
I'd say.
Jeez.
And again, the kick is deep. Trey Franks can't handle it. Oklahoma has to work from the 20-yard line. Landry Jones fanned one, lost the handle. Oklahoma State, if it's not a pass, it's a touchdown. Richetti Jones, and it looks like it indeed is another Cowboy score.
Well, his hand and arm was definitely coming forward. The question is, did the ball come out before? I think it did. I think the ball came out as it was going back. The arm came forward without the football, and I think that's going to stand as a fumble.
They'll take a look at this one, obviously. But after fumbling earlier and having Blatnick go all the way down to the 1-yard line, another disastrous turnover, if indeed it is, for Oklahoma. Sharp for the point after. Boy, they are enjoying it right now at Boone Pickens Stadium. At least everybody that's decked in orange and black. Another disastrous turnover. The Cowboys find the handle and the end zone, and it's 34-3. Back in Stillwater, they're almost partying already. Oklahoma State by 31, and we've still got 11:56 to go in the third quarter. Try to snap an 8-game losing skid. Landry Jones has had a couple of fumbles, one that was returned to the 1-yard line. The last one was returned to the end zone. And the Sooners are in a huge hole. See if they can dig themselves out. Trey Franks from the 6. And Franks out to the 25-yard line. On the ground, Finch. To the 30.
You know, that Virginia Tech game means something to the people here in Stillwater, because in the human polls, Virginia Tech is ahead of Oklahoma State. And the way that the Cowboys are playing tonight, if this holds up, if that holds up in Charlotte, Stanford, the other team ahead of them, not playing. They didn't get to play in the Pac-12 championship game last night. So that game has a lot of meaning to the folks here.
Play fake. They whip it out to Trey Franks. Franks has got a first down, puts his head down, barrels his way to the 40. Justin Gilbert met him there, but a 10-yard pickup. Oklahoma, they have no trouble huddling, because very seldom do they. So they hustle up to the line, preserving every precious second. First down, just shaded on the Sooner side of midfield. Williams met in the hole, only got about a yard. And it was Sean Lewis, who's had another exceptional game at the outside linebacker spot for Oklahoma State.
I tell you, I think the week off that Oklahoma State had really benefited them in a lot of ways. I mean, they're a very fresh-looking football team tonight defensively. Got a lot of speed, a lot of jump in their step tonight. Offensively, their running game has been much better than it's been the last few weeks.
Jones throws on the run, completes it, or did he? Millard, did he trap it? The official's going to give him the catch. Millard, the fullback, lays out. Yeah, looked pretty good from there.
Yeah, that was a pretty good effort.
And now Williams, and now he lost the ball. And the Cowboys have got it. Levy made the hit.
Well, one of the things that we said for Oklahoma State to have a chance to win, one of their keys was to win the turnover battle.
That's four.
That makes it 4-0. That's winning it.
Winning it big. There's Levy with a hit right on the ball. And Collins, 98, is going to be the guy that comes into the back of the play and finds the football. The wheels are falling off the Boomer Schooner right now. Cowboys again in Sooner territory at the 40. They might want a big hit right here. On the sideline, and a little miscommunication between receiver Justin Blackmon and his quarterback. We asked Raymond Whedon yesterday, what was the game? And I said, I understand that question's tied together. He said, for me personally, beating Oklahoma. For the program and Oklahoma State, it's getting to a BCS game and winning a conference crown. So while they're tied together, it meant more to him to beat the guys in the crimson and white. And here's Smith breaking free again and scoring again. Touchdown. He scored the first one of the night. Now he's got a 37-yarder to his credit. And now the question starts being, how much of a statement are they making? And will they start to sway the voters' minds a little bit? Because this is becoming a rout against the number 10 team in the country. The number 3 team is making a statement, 41-3.
Jeremy Smith just ran through the arm tackle of Corey Nelson. Corey Nelson, normally a dependable linebacker. Watch number 7. He's unblocked. He gets an arm around him, but that's not enough. And Jeremy Smith fights through it. And at the end of the play, Tracy Moore, the wide receiver, number 87, gets a great block. And Smith able to waltz into the end zone.
Jeremy Smith out of Tulsa Union. Their team just won another 6A title a couple of days ago. There's a lot of kids from that high school on these two teams. They beat Jenks in the semifinals. They beat Broken Arrow by a point. Between Jenks and Tulsa Union, I think they have the last 16 6A championships in this state. They put out a lot of good football players.
Yes, they do.
Wow. I didn't see this one coming, partner.
No, I didn't either. I thought there'd be a lot of points, but I thought they'd be on both sides of the ledger.
Exactly. Sharp's kick might be returnable this time for Trey Franks. And flies across the 25 to about the 26-yard line. And the Cowboys stop Brandon Williams. Sean Lewis drops him for a loss. Sean Lewis, the outside linebacker, having another big game. And it brings up long yardage, and that's not something that Oklahoma wants to be in. They're minus on the rushing category. And we're less than 5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Second down and 12. Jones, and he has another one. His arm apparently hit as that just flops out of bounds near the 30-yard line. We're talking about Tyrann Mathieu.
He's one of mine.
Is he?
Yeah, he is. You know, in the thing that Joe Tessitore, the little Heismanology, last week when I sent my three guys in, he was one of my three. And so
nothing's changed your mind, that's for sure.
No, outstanding player.
Landry Jones, plenty of time this time. And drop ball, Finch didn't hold it. That's the way the night's been going for the Sooners.
You know, I want to get back to a little bit. You were talking about the statement that Oklahoma State is making. Mike Gundy made a statement. He said, as of 2008, he said he thinks this team can play with anybody, anytime, anywhere. And I wondered about that because of their defense. But if their defense plays the way they play tonight,
yeah,
I'd have to agree. They can play with anybody.
Tress Way has been a way too busy putter tonight for Oklahoma. Got a nice kick away, though, again under heavy pressure. And this time, no fair catch taken by Cooper. He's going to finally field one. And it goes down in his tracks, basically, at the 26-yard line. Cowboys with the ball back. Less than 4.5 to go in the third quarter. And there goes Randall again, all the way to midfield.
Well, they're just ripping them now.
Yeah, they are.
I mean, it's just, you know, they feel it, they smell it, they taste it, and it's just full throttle. You got a defense that's tired, that's cold. They don't want to tackle right now, and Oklahoma State just keeps it going.
First down at the 48. Whedon flares it out. Randall, this time out of the backfield. He's got another first down and a lot more. Joseph Randall, who had some fumble problems in that loss to Iowa State, and he's holding on to everything tonight.
Now, Justin Blackman, we know he's a great receiver, the premier one in college football, possibly also doing his job as a blocker on the perimeter on that play for Randall.
First down at the 35. Inside handoff. And here goes Smith again. Wow, what a 1-2 punch Smith and Randall have been. 15 more yards. So it was 24 yards for Randall. 17 on a draw play. Now 15 for number 31, who's having a huge night.
Well, and the Oklahoma State offensive staff has to be thrilled with the way they're running the football. That was the thing they knew they had to do better at coming into this game. Only 60 yards against Iowa State in that lone loss.
Here's that little handoff on the inside fly sweep. Josh Stewart this time gets the carry. And picks up about 3. So we're down to 3 remaining in the third quarter. Back in the red zone. And up 41-3. Oklahoma State routing the Sooners right now. Brandon Whedon fires to the end zone, just off the outstretched arms of Josh Stewart.
Yeah, just a hair high. The timing was good. The opening was there. The ball just a little too tall for Josh Stewart. Perfect timing on the throw right out of the break. And if that's lower, it's a touchdown before Jefferson gets there for the hit.
Or if Josh is 6'1 instead of 5'10, yeah, it might have been a touchdown. Randall back into the backfield, third down at 8. Blackman, he gets that flip again. And this time, Oklahoma waiting for him, maybe a yard gain, and that's it. Demontre Hurst made the stop. And out comes the field goal unit. Quinn Sharp's hit a couple tonight. 25 and 37. And this one's going to be right about 34. Trying to add to a lead and give the Cowboys a 40-point. 44-3 lead. And less than 2 minutes.
Here's the deal. Their defense tonight has shown me something. You know, coming into the game, they were giving up more yards per game and points per game than Alabama and LSU combined. This is a different defense tonight.
Kick. Roy Finch will take a knee, and Oklahoma will have to work from the 20-yard line. Less than 2 minutes to go, third quarter. I'm not sure there's anything the Sooners can do about this, but they're obviously going to keep trying for the next 17 minutes. On the ground, Millard, the fullback. Maybe they should have used him a little bit more tonight. He's a very versatile fullback. Great out of the backfield. That time got close to 10, if he didn't get 10 on the run. And he's just a yard shy, less than a yard shy of the first down. He stays in there as the single setback.
There's the running back coach for Oklahoma, Cale Gundy, the brother of Mike Gundy.
It is. Millard again got the first down, spins his way out for four before Levy made the hit. There's Kale. So brother against brother. Mike, the quarterback here, back in his day. There was a time when he was playing quarterback and they had some pretty good talent around him that they thought they were going to pull off an upset over what was considered the big brothers. The big brothers might be switching around a little bit tonight. First and 10, Sooners, final minute, third quarter. On their own 33. Play action. Landry Jones fires deep middle. That should have been caught, I thought, unless John Lewis got a hand in there to knock it out of Stills' gut. A pretty good throw. Kenny Stills, the intended receiver. You know, you have to wonder what difference, and I'm sure it would have made one, Ryan Broyles, if he was on the field tonight.
Well, Broyles and Whaley, again, two key offensive weapons that they've played the last part of this season without. Whaley, a physical runner, and Broyles, a do-everything receiver.
Millard, another good run, another first down. Roderick Brown put the hit on him, but he got out to the 45, maybe the 46-yard line.
I think that's why we're seeing Millard right now. I mean, he gives them a little strength.
There's Dominic Whaley over there with the crutches. Again, broke his ankle on the first play against Kansas State. And he was a walk-on, and he was having this marvelous season. He will not be a walk-on in another month. He gets the first open scholarship in January. Miller getting some serious work here. Cut down that time, though, by Daytwan Lowe, who hit him low.
Yeah, he went low, didn't he?
And that should do it for the third quarter. Already the Cowboys holding up four fingers. I don't blame them. This presentation of ESPN and ABC College Football presented by Southwest Airlines continues after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Set to start the fourth quarter in our Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines, and Oklahoma State is 15 minutes away from being Big 12 conference champions and entering the BCS. 30-point wins in series history. The Sooners have had 26. Oklahoma State won. Oklahoma State has only won this battle five times since World War II, because there's going to be a celebration in Stillwater tonight.
Well, you know, the drum that they will beat the loudest here in Stillwater tonight and through the weekend and next week will be those quality wins, the number of quality wins over ranked opponents that this Oklahoma State team can boast compared to what Alabama can boast. But again, there's that perception the SEC is still the strongest conference, so therefore Alabama has a little bit more weight.
Again, this will be the fifth win over a BCS top 25 team for Oklahoma State. Here's Millard. And he's a couple yards shy of the first down as we check in with Holly.
Well, this is arguably one of the biggest games in Oklahoma State history. So we were wondering if Mike Gundy would get tight, how he would coach tonight. Well, it was a good signal when he told us that yesterday morning he spent his time digging trenches on his 70-acre farm here in Stillwater, laying some power lines, some telephone lines. He said, you know, I've been involved in sports since I was 5 years old, playing year-round. I know how to focus during a game, and his demeanor has been very calm here on the sidelines, guys.
Tell you what, his team's laid some power lines down tonight on Oklahoma.
I hope he's got some long underwear on, because he's going to get Gatorade here in a very short amount of time.
First down run. A little skirmish on the bottom of the pile as we're under 5 minutes.
I'll tell you, the happiest guy in this stadium might be Bill Young, because the defensive coordinator for a team coming in that was 107th in the nation in total defense has put on a show tonight and made them look like a legitimate national championship caliber team.
We'll take the eighth highest scoring offense in the nation and held them to a field goal, which came on the final play of the second quarter. Here's a little flare out to Trey Franks. Tyler Johnson made the tackle on Franks. And Franks limping off as he did earlier in this half. Sooners are going to come up short of a 10-win season. That doesn't happen very often. Of course, they could get the 10th win in their bowl game, wherever that might be. You'll find out about all the bowls starting at 8 o'clock tomorrow night on ESPN, 8:15 rather, and continuing at 9 o'clock when you'll find out, after you find out who's going to play in the national championship game, you'll find out about the rest of the bowls. Sooners have won 4 of the last 5 Big 12 crowns. And they had won the last 8 straight in this Bedlam matchup. That was another nice stop by Sean Lewis, who's had a huge game. The sophomore out of Missouri City, Texas.
Well, he did a great job of running down the line of scrimmage. He came off the edge, saw the handoff, and then straight down the line of scrimmage to make a play for the stop short of the first down.
Fourth and a long one. Blake Bell's in for the first time tonight, the short yardage quarterback. They haven't had any short yardage or goal line situations, so he hadn't had a chance to play.
How about that? He's been such a big part of their offense over the last 4 or 5 weeks. First time in the game.
Redshirt freshman, all 6'6", 250 pounds of him. And he'll just run it behind his blockers. And he's got the first down. He might have a touchdown. And does. Bell for the score, the first touchdown of the night for Oklahoma. 29-yard rumble.
Most of his runs have been inside. This time they take it outside. Jaden Bird, number 53, with a key block right on the edge. And a little different look out of that power formation, the Belldozer package. And Blake Bell gets his 10th rushing touchdown of the season.
That's tops on the team. But it's way too little and way too late. So it was a good-looking play. And he's the future quarterback for the Sooners. And finally, they get a touchdown, but it comes with 2:25 remaining in the football game. Landry Jones couldn't get him in the end zone. Blake Bell did, but did it with his legs. 44-10. In Afghanistan, morning now. Breakfast has already been served, and notice has been served on the Sooners by Oklahoma State tonight. We'll take a look at our Pacific Live game summary. 247 yards on the ground for the Cowboys. Turnover story 5-1 now, and that led to the only Sooner touchdown after Jeremy Smith fumbled. They get down, and Blake Bell gets him in the end zone on a 29-yard run. But all Cowboys 44-10.
Yeah, they protected their quarterback, Brandon Weeden. No touchdowns, but no sacks and no rug burns either.
No.
I mean, he was not on the ground.
And I'm sure, even though first game he hasn't had a touchdown pass, he's not going to care at all after what he talked to us about what this game meant and being able to beat Oklahoma. That's a free ball. He finally found the handle, Justin Gilbert. And Gilbert stopped at the 20. Final couple of minutes. More ground game here. And another couple of yards. Herschel Sims on the carry. Oops. Todd was just talking about hoping Mike has long undies on. I hope he does too.
Yeah.
Well. He didn't change expression much, did he? Oh, boy. He'll enjoy it more and more as the night and the weekend progresses. And we talked about the storm forecast for Stillwater. You can see that some of the fans are lining up to be part of the field when it's over. The Sims again on the carry. Oklahoma State up 34. It's going to be one of the largest wins in history for them. 47 back in 45. The celebration is close at hand now with just over a minute to play.
Well, my advice to players on both teams, particularly the ones from Oklahoma, put your helmets on and strap up your chin straps before before the field gets covered with folks.
Herschel Sims getting a few carries here at the very end. We might or might not have another snap. You're number one in the Big 12, Spider-Man. Tell you that much. Champions of the Big 12 for the first time. And Bedlam about to become mayhem. Congratulations to the Cowboys of Oklahoma State. They snap an eight-game losing skid to the Sooners, and they are Big 12 champions headed to the BCS. Here's Holly.
Well, Coach Gundy, this is the first time you've been able to beat Oklahoma, but how do you describe beating them like this?
Well, our players had really two really good weeks of practice, and these are special kids. I told them in the locker room before the game that they're a special group, and they deserve it. They've worked for a long time, and so they've earned it.
You guys really made a dramatic change in your running game tonight, over 270 yards rushing. How were you able to do that?
Well, our offensive staff felt like that we had to be able to run the football. That's where we came up short at Iowa State. And, well, you got to give a lot of credit to our defense. It's unbelievable what our defense did. But the kids really played hard, and it's all about them. I'm really proud of them.
Coach, I know you wanted to win a conference championship first before you talk about this. You've won it tonight. Now how do you make your case for this team deserving a shot at the national championship?
Well, I think people have to decide whether they want to see a 9-6 game or a 39-36 game. And I think this is the opportunity for people to find out how good the defense is in the SEC. We'd love to have that challenge. I think our defense is better than what other people say. So, you know, last week, you know, I said Alabama should be there. There's no question Oklahoma State should be number two right now. No question.
Thank you, Coach.
You bet.
Todd said earlier, I wonder if the tune for Coach Gundy will change. He's whistling something different, isn't he? That's okay. He's got reason to brag up his team after a resounding win tonight. 44-10 is the final. So finally, the long wait is over for a conference championship. This isn't the Big 8 back in the mid-70s. This is the 2011 version of the Big 12, and the champions are the Cowboys of Oklahoma State. Final score, 44-10 for Todd Blackledge, Holly Rowe, and our entire crew. Brad Nessler saying so long from Stillwater. Time to head to Robert Flores with the Ford wrap-up show. Congratulations to the Cowboys.